On November 11th at 9:30 Universal Time in 2018, a mysterious occurrence took place deep under the water. 15 miles off the French island of Mayotte near the coast of Madagascar, inexplicable seismic waves rocked the Earth's crust. But these were no ordinary waves. Normally, seismic waves such as those from an earthquake last up to 30 seconds at a maximum. Think of them as a sudden pop as built-up tension in the Earth's crust release with a jolt in mere seconds, from which waves ripple out across the Earth from the point of the rupture. But what happened off the coast of Mayotte didn't last for 30 seconds. It occurred for a full 20 minutes. That's 40 times the length of your average earthquake. But that isn't the end to the weirdness. These seismic waves were detected up to 11,000 miles away, traversing oceans to be picked up by sensors in Chile, Canada, and even the UK at record speeds. This meant the waves spanned the distance between Mayotte to Hawaii in just 1 hour and 15 minutes. But the weirdest thing about these waves is yet to come. In fact, everything about these waves was strange. One noticeable difference between them and other earthquake waves was their formation. Regular quakes occur when the tectonic plates of the Earth's crust bump into each other as they float on a lubricant layer called the asthenosphere. We detect them using a seismograph, which usually looks like this. As you can see, they're made up of P and S waves. P waves, also known as primary waves, highlight compression that takes place as soon as tension is released through an earthquake. They can best be described as following the pattern a slinky would make if you squashed it. After P waves comes S waves, or secondary waves, which follow a simple side-to-side wave movement and are slower, but larger in magnitude than P waves. After these waves, slow, longer period surface waves show up third in line. So what's so special about the waves off Mayotte? Well, they did something no one has ever seen before. They moved in a zigzag motion, with one particular wave repeating itself exactly every 17 seconds. Usual waves from seismic phenomena are at a high frequency, rather than a low and gradual rumble like the ones witnessed off Mayotte. Also, the frequencies of normal earthquakes are seen to jump around and vary their tones. These ones, however, were completely monotonous, meaning they were just one continuous, low, monochromatic tone. Comparing their pattern to a normal earthquake on a seismograph, they just don't match up. Strange, right? But what's even stranger is that to this day, not only was no one hurt by this event, there has never been a single report of anyone even feeling them, ever. Seriously, these waves ran through the planet for 20 minutes straight, reaching 11,000 miles, and not a single person felt anything. So how do we know they even happened? Well, it all came down to one very observant seismologist and Twitter user, @MatarikiPax. One day as he partook in the extreme sport of watching the US Geological Survey's real-time seismogram displays, he noticed something a bit odd about the zigzag patterns he was witnessing. He was also curious as to why nobody else was noticing them. To see if anyone else had any thoughts on the peculiar waves, he took to Twitter and set off his own earth-shattering chain of events. This now viral post sent seismologists around the globe into a frenzy as they tried to figure out this geological mystery. Seismologist at Columbia University Goran Ekstrom was quoted as saying, "I don't think I've seen anything like it." A bold statement from an expert who has studied thousands upon thousands of seismic waves. So what the heck happened? Have any of the experts come up with a theory about what could have caused these peculiar waves? Was it a huge monster from the deep? Maybe some man-made activities taking place in the depths of the ocean? Well, right now there are many theories floating around the internet attempting to give us an explanation, and you'll soon find out that some are more believable than others. Of course, when unexplained phenomena and the internet collide, weird and wacky theories always find their way onto social media. This has made way for a whole host of crazy explanations for the waves ranging from a meteor strike to sea monsters. However, despite extensive searches, there has been no evidence to date of a meteor ever landing anywhere near Mayotte. And as for sea monsters, there's not a whole lot of evidence for those either. Although the notion of sea monsters is most likely fueled by folklore, with many cultures around the world having their own myths and legends surrounding the cause of earthquakes and the sea. One example is Poseidon, who was the god of the sea and was said to have been able to shake the ground with his trident. Meanwhile in Japan, earthquakes were thought to have been caused by a monstrous catfish called the Namazu. Another peculiar and also controversial argument presented by internet theorists is that the unusual waves were caused by human activity beneath the ocean. This is because there are various reports stating the phenomenon off Mayotte were more mechanical in nature, rather than something capable of being produced by Mother Nature. Volcanologist Helen Robinson at Glasgow University was quoted as saying the waves were too nice, they're too perfect to be nature. Meanwhile, other scientists have supported the claim that human machinery could be behind the unusual and regular patterns and frequencies of the waves. This is mainly due to the highly artificial nature of the waves, with some theorists describing them as being something more likely to have come from a musical instrument. Indeed, some scientists have even gone as far as to suggest the Earth was rung like a massive bell. The tiny pings literally occurred like clockwork. It's quite spooky, really. But what kind of human activity could have caused this seismic phenomenon? Could it be that the Earth's crust is really being played like a musical instrument? A plethora of theories have sprung up, ranging from fracking to secret underground nuclear testing facilities. However, these are highly unlikely, as there's no evidence to suggest human activity is present in that area of the seabed. If we take a step back, you'll see we have a theory of mistaking highly rhythmic signals for something that they're not. In the 1960s, for instance, we thought pulsars were proof of alien life because they rapidly rotated and flashed in regular, calculated intervals. We now know they're highly magnetized rotating neutron stars, but back then, their signals were nicknamed LGMs, little green men. So the truth is, we've been fooled before, and no evidence currently exists of something man-made that's large enough to produce this global ringing. Not that we know about, at least. But what really set the conspiracy sphere on fire was that the events off Mayotte were surprisingly close to events detailed in a mysterious WikiLeaks report published back in 2013. The disturbing report, prepared by Admiral Makhachev of Russia's Northern Fleet for Vladimir Putin, claimed that a mysterious magnetic vortex which occurred in the Gulf of Aden had been opened in the late months of the year 2000. According to the report, a coalition of the US, Russia, and China cast aside their differences to study what the vortex was and discovered it defied logic and the laws of physics. After this vortex, there were official reports stating 35 earthquakes rocked the Earth in the Gulf of Aden in just 24 hours. Could this be what happened off the coast of Mayotte? Of course, rather quickly after the signals from Mayotte were detected, conspiracy theorists resurrected the story of the vortex, questioning why else geopolitical adversaries would cooperate, if not because of some incredibly important force or event they don't want us to know about. The government's cover story was that all the navies of each nation joined together to combat Somali pirates. But why would such a crazy amount of firepower be needed for pirates? In fact, quite quickly, it was then connected to the Norwegian spiral anomaly from 2009, with people drawing links to the film Stargate, in which ancient extraterrestrial civilization possessed a gate to travel through time and space to other dimensions. People have even gone as far to suggest it's another experiment in weather manipulation. After all, we know that the governments have experimented with weather manipulation, from the US during the Vietnam War to present-day China. But the truth is, the source of the WikiLeaks article is questionable, to say the least. Also, the location of the mysterious waves were in an incredibly remote region. Although they're nearby Mayotte, they're actually a 7-hour plane journey away, and are likely way too remote for some secretive operation or human project. So putting vortexes and aliens aside, is there scientific evidence to show something more earthly took place? Currently, most seismologists agree the most plausible explanation is that it was caused by a combination of tectonic and volcanic effects, either a strange earthquake or due to some type of volcanic activity. The French Geological Survey stated a new center of volcanic activity may be developing 50 kilometers off the coast of Mayotte. This is where the epicenter of the activity appears to take place and is estimated to be around 20 kilometers in diameter. Indeed, the island has previously been a hotbed for volcanic activity, although they've been lying dormant for over 4,000 years. This wave may point to new offshore activity, such as an eruption or an incredibly strange earthquake of some sort. Over the last year, the island has been struck by hundreds of tremors, with the largest reaching a 5.8 magnitude on the Richter scale on May the 15th, the biggest on record for the island. Still, these tremors weren't like the mystery wave. They followed the regular P&S waves. To reconcile that fact, perhaps it was a very rare type of slow-relating earthquake known as earthquake swarms. Although these types of quakes seldom happen, they have occurred in recent years over the course of a few days or even a few weeks in the most extreme cases. But possibly the most likely explanation comes from ENS University in Paris, who hypothesize it was due to magma draining from a site somewhere, possibly from a subterranean reservoir. Using GPS and geological data, they suggested this body of magma could be up to a third of a cubic mile large, and is now forcing its way up through the subsurface near the island. Think of it as a large earthly pimple that's popping its magma across the lithosphere, a pimple hotter than the depths of hell. Though rare, they aren't unheard of. In fact, one just like this happened recently in the Democratic Republic of Congo, where a magma chamber collapsed, creating a slow, rumbling earthquake throughout the lithosphere. So, what's the general consensus? It's hard to say, but it's likely due to a more mundane explanation. Currently, no evidence has emerged that can say for certain what created the seismic waves. So right now, literally no one knows what happened or why. This means the jury's still out, and for the time being, the waves remain very much a mystery. So what do you think? Do you reckon it's a slow-releasing earthquake? A meteor? Or maybe even aliens? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section down below. Thanks for watching.